In the past, I've shown you how to come up with an equation when someone gives you a line. So now, now we're going to work the other way around. We're going to get given an equation, and then you have to be able to draw this line, and you have to be able to do this in your sleep. So it's quite important. It's an important skill. So learn to do it, and it's difficult at first, but when you keep on practicing, it becomes really easy. But the important thing is you have to be able to do this inside your sleep, because it's an important skill. Okay. So now I'm going to show you how to sketch this. So look at this. Remember, it's y equals equals mx plus c. Well, this here is your gradient, which means that this is your gradient, and this is your intercept. This is your intercept. So the intercept would be 1. So you know it's going to pass this point here. Okay. So when someone gives you an equation like this, look at the intercept first. Okay. Look at the intercept. So the intercept is C. Now look at the gradient. The gradient of 2, it means it has a steepness of 2. So what that means is the up and down here will be 2 and the across will be 1. So that means it has a steepness of 2. You see that here? So when someone gives you this, look at the intercept. You know it crosses this bit here. Okay? And then you know it. Then you would look at this here. It has a gradient of 2, which means it has a steepness of 2. So you know it's going to 2 here divided by 1 here, and then 1 across, 2 up, because you know that the up and down, the height will be 2. Remember, 2 over 1, that's what it means. This 2 over 1 is the gradient here. So that means it's 2 up and then 1 across. So it has a steepness of, well, anyway. So it's going to be like this. Okay. So when you sketch this, start with the intercept and then look at the steepness or the gradient. So this here would be your straight line. Okay. And anyway, it has an intercept of 1. Okay. So let's have a look at the next one here. Let's try and sketch this one here. So here, you would look at the line y equals mx plus c. What this has done is that this here, the way it's written here, is actually c plus mx. But because the gradient, the reason why it's written like this is because rather than writing it as this minus 4x plus 8, they would switch it around because it looks neater when you have the positive here in front and the negative after. So this is a proper way of writing it, but when you come to visualize this thing here, visualize it as this. Hang on, y equals minus 4x plus 8. Okay. When it's written like this, visualize it inside your mind. Visualize it like this. So here the intercept is at 8. Okay. So it would be here. The intercept is at 8. Okay, and then it has a gradient of negative 4. Well, a gradient of 4 means it's the up and down is 4, the across is 1. But because it's a negative, the gradient here is a negative, so the up and down is still 4, but it's going in this direction. Okay, it's going in this direction here. So hang on. So what that means is, it has a gradient, the up and down would be 4, but it's because it's a negative gradient, so it's got to be here. Because if you look at this here, the up and down here is 4, the across is 1. So when you come to work out the gradient, you would have 4, divided by 1. But look at this, it's going downhill. Okay, so it has to be in this direction. If it has a gradient of 4, it would mean this. It would mean up and down here. If it has a gradient of positive 4, it would mean this, positive. Can you see that? It's going uphill. Well, anyway, looking at this here, inside your mind, visualize this, y equals minus 4x plus c, plus 8. So this here is your intercept, 8, okay, which is at this point here. And the gradient is minus 4. So when you come to draw this or sketch this, it will be this. Can you see that? 4 up, the up and down is 4 and 1 across. 4 divided by 1 here. So it's going to be like this. And then you would just join them up. It's hard for me to join these up, by the way. Okay. So this is your supposedly straight line. Okay. So the equation, when you come to draw this, the line would look something like this. Okay. It should be a straight line. Okay. And if you get given some, so we've done this. We haven't done this. So now when someone gives you this one here, okay. Look at this here. This is your M here. This is your C. Okay. It's a negative C. So the intercept is at -3. So hang on. The intercept is at -3. So it's got to be, here. Okay. Now look at the gradient. The gradient is 1/4. So what that means is the up and down is 1 and the across is 4. So it's going to look like, and this is a positive gradient. If it's -1/4, then it's going to be like this. 4 across. So it's going to be in this direction. Okay. Well, anyway, a gradient of a quarter will look, the up and down will be 1 and the across would be 4. So it's quite shallow. Okay. So anyway, we've got our intercept -3. Now we need a gradient of 1/4. 1/4, it means, well, the up and down is 1 and the across is 4. So go across 4. Okay. And then 1 up. Across 4 and then 1 up. Across 4 and then 1 up. Here it's going to be like this. A 4 across, okay, 4 across. So it's going to be like this, and then somehow join these up. Yeah. So this here, this is our line, okay. And the last one, suppose you're given this here. You know when you have a over 2 plus B over 2, because the two denominators are the same, you can merge the two together. So it's like this. Well, here we're going to work the other way around. So we are here. We're going to break them up into this A over 2, plus B over 2. So basically, I'm going to break this fraction up in the middle here. Okay. So when you are given this here, break it up. So it's like this, 5x over 2 and then minus 4 over 2. Okay. 4 over 2. Well, here, let's take the x out of this fraction. So it's like this, 5 over 2x, minus, 4 over 2 is just 2. Okay. So the intercept is -2. So when you're given this here, break it up. So now visualize it inside your mind as this. Okay. This is your intercept. This is your gradient. I will explain the gradient later. So the intercept is at -2. So we know the intercept is right here. Okay. Now the gradient of 5 over 2. 5 over 2, what that means is it has a height of 5 and the 2 across. That's what it means. So a steepness of 5 over 2 means the height of 5, the acrossness, if that makes sense, is 2. So you know the intercept is here. Now the steepness is 5 up, 2 across. Okay. So 5 up, where there, 2, 4, 5. So it's going to be here. If you look at this here, it's 5 up and 2 across. Okay. And then do the 5 up again and 2. So we've done the 2 across and then do the 5 up. So it's going to be here. Well, anyway, hang on. So we know the intercept is going to be at -2. So the gradient of 5 over 2 means, well, 2 across, 5 up. It will mean this. 2 across, 5 up. Remember, it's always 5 over 2. Okay. Here, hang on, 5 down and 2 across. So now our straight line will look something like this. There, that's the equation. So when you get given this, you should be able to jump to this. And remember, this is an important skill. When someone gives you an equation of a straight line, you have to be able to sketch it, and you have to do it in your sleep. So keep on practicing. In the next video, I will give you some practice, okay?